Hi, I'm Judy Hash with Lynchburg's Public Works Department. I'm part of a team responsible for educating our citizens about trash collection in the city. You will see me and my partner Greg inspecting household trash, bulk, and brush setouts all over the city of Lynchburg. We inspect every street. If you see us out on the street or at one of the 5 recycling locations, stop and chat. We love to talk trash.
And I'm Greg Haith. Today we're going to talk about brush and bulk. We understand that piles of uncollected bulk and brush can be a real eyesore for a neighborhood. So we developed a system for collecting that bulk and brush in a timely manner, but it only works with your cooperation. So we are here to explain the city's bulk and brush collection guidelines.
The first thing to know is your brush and bulk is collected according to the day your regular trash is picked up. For instance, if your trash is collected on a Monday, brush and bulk in your neighborhood will be picked up the first full week of the month. If you're a Tuesday trash pickup, brush and bulk gets collected the second week following the first full week of the month. Wednesday is the third week, and Thursday is the fourth week. There's a color-coded map on the city's website that shows which collection zone you live in.
Here's why this is so important. Nobody wants to see piles of brush and bulk sitting on the side of their road for days on end. Bulk and brush are collected on a schedule. Make sure you place your items at the curb no earlier than 7 a.m. the Saturday before your designated collection week, and no later than 7 a.m. on the Monday of your designated collection week. If it's set out no later than 7 a.m. on Monday of your collection week, our crews should get to it one day that week.
Okay, so you got the schedule down. Now here are some important tips on how to place your bulk and brush by the curb. First, brush and bulk should be kept in separate piles. The reason for this is we have trucks that only collect brush and others that only collect bulk. Those trucks go to separate places in the landfill for disposal.
Your brush pile shouldn't contain any tree trimmings longer than 8 feet or wider than 3 inches in diameter. If you have a small pile of debris, please place it in a bag and put it in your trash cart or place it in a prepaid bag for collection. This enables us to utilize our brush trucks more efficiently. And remember, the city does not collect brush or bulk debris resulting from contracted services.
Brush can only be set out at the property it was generated. And remember, leaves are only collected during the fall leaf season. Please do not rake them into the street for brush collection.
Bulk items include things like furniture, white goods like old appliances, mattresses, and box springs. Bulk is large items that do not fit into a prepaid bag or trash cart. It does not include plastic bags of any kind, cardboard boxes, household trash, loose or bagged, clothing or bedding, porcelain-like items such as toilets or sinks, items containing glass such as mirrors, pictures, or shelves, TV or computer monitors, pallets, fencing, or landscaping timbers, contractor, remodeling, or demolition materials including flooring, sheetrock, carpeting, insulation, wood, or roofing.
The city does not collect material from landlord setouts, from eviction setouts, or from property cleanouts. Bulk items not collected by the city's bulk trucks can be taken to the landfill convenience center by the homeowner. Lynchburg residents may take up to 500 pounds of household trash and unlimited bulk or brush each month, free of charge, to the Concord Turnpike Convenience Center in Lynchburg. Make sure bulk and brush are separated. And again, if a contractor has done work for you resulting in construction debris, it is their responsibility to dispose of it.
When you're placing your brush or bulk curbside, remember to keep it away from things like fire hydrants, mailboxes, power poles, trees, or parked cars. Anything that would make it harder for our boom trucks to reach it. You should also avoid leaving it underneath power lines, as there may not be enough room for the truck to safely operate.
All this seems like a lot to remember, but once you get in the habit of setting out your bulk and brush in a safe, proper, and timely manner, everyone will benefit.
And working together, we can all help to keep Lynchburg a clean, safe, beautiful place to live, work, and play. If you have any questions, you can call our Citizens First Information Center at 434-856-CITY or go to the city website at lynchburgva.gov. Thanks for watching.